Hi friends, welcome to my channel. This video I'll teach you about what is socket programming and how to create a socket programming application in Python. Also I'll demonstrate how to create a simple chat application program. So what is a socket programming? You can use socket programming for creating a network based application system. So socket programming enables communication between application that is running on the computers in the network. So basically it will create a inter-process communication between two applications in the network. So for example, here you can assume a network of two computers. Assume that there is a Python program called client program and we have a Python server program. With the help of socket programming, you can make these two applications communicate each other. So what is exactly socket? Socket creates a communication endpoint by which we can send or receive data in a network. So this socket you can develop as a software object with the help of IP address and port number. You can configure the socket as a client socket or server socket. If you configure as a server socket, you have to make the server socket to listen in a particular IP address and the port number. Similarly, if you create a socket as a client, you have to make the client socket to request to the server socket. So next we have IP address and port number. So IP address and port number plays an important role in socket programming. So where IP address is a numerical number which is assigned to every computer in the network. It is used to identify the computer physically so that we can connect to the system before exchanging any data. So it is a numerical number. For example, the pattern of the IP address is 192.168.12.10. It is used to connect the system physically. So once you connect the system physically, we can identify the application running on the system. So to direct the data to a particular application or process, we need a port number. So port number is a number which is uniquely identifies the application or process in the system. So usually the range of port number is 0 to 65,535. So within this range you can use any number as a port number. So then we have a servers and clients. So server and clients plays an important role in socket programming, where server is a program or a device which will have the resources or data which is required by the client. And this server can be a same in your system. You can configure your local system as a server, or it can be a remote computer system. In every computer, you can find a local server which is called as localhost. Its IP address is 127.0.0.1. And client is a software program or device which will request data or resources from the server. So next we have socket programming with TCP. So actually there are two ways you can implement socket programming. You can implement socket programming with the TCP protocol, or you can implement socket programming with the UDP protocol. So this video I'll teach you about how to create a socket programming with the TCP protocol. As you know that TCP protocol is a transmission control protocol which is actually available in OSI layer, that is for data transfer. You can achieve reliable data transfer between client and the server. It is basically a connection oriented service where you need to make a connection before exchanging the data. So there are three phases. First you have to make a connection. Once a connection is created, we can exchange the data. So once a data is exchanged, we can close the connection, and it is highly reliable than the UDP protocol. In other case, there is another way of socket programming is with UDP protocol. So UDP is a connectionless service where you don't require any connection before exchanging the data. So here in socket programming with TCP layer, here you can see there is a layer called application, and then followed by there is a layer called transport layer. So in transport layer, there is a protocol called TCP which will send and receive the data. So before sending and receiving data, we have to create a socket and bind with IP address and port number in order to make the application to send the data. So next is how to implement TCP socket programming in Python. If you want to create a socket programming application in Python, first you need to import the socket module or a framework. So this socket module provides a set of methods which you can use to create socket, and we can make the socket to send and receive data between two programs that is running in the network in a different computers. So this socket module provides a basic methods. For example, we have socket method. This method you can use to create a server socket and client socket. Also we have bind. Using bind function, we can bind IP address and port number with the server. It is used by the server machine. and we have a listen function. So it is used to make the server socket to listen at a particular port number. Then we have a connect method. Using connect method, the client can make a request to the particular server socket. And there is another function called accept. This function is used by the server socket to accept the connection from the client. So by make use of these methods, we can build a network based application using socket programming. So next we will see the TCP socket programming model in Python. So in Python, if you want to develop a socket programming, you will have to create two programs. One is for server program, another one is for client. In server side, you have to create a build a socket, then you have to bind with IP address and port number. And after binding with IP address and port number, you have to make the server socket to listen in the port number by calling a listen function. Then in the client side, you have to create a socket, then you have to make a connect. You have to make a request to the server by using a connect method. So once the connect method is accepted by the server, the connection will be created. So for that, the server side, we have to call accept method. After calling accept method, the connection, logical connection will be created between the server and client. Now we can exchange the data. To exchange the data, there are two functions. One is send function, next one is receive function. So you will be getting two logical connection. One is send and receive. From server side, the send is connected to the receiving end of the client. Similarly, from client side, the send is connected to the receiving end of the server side. So using this stream, we can exchange data. So once you complete the exchange of data, you can go for closing the connection. So this is what the overall programming model. So now let me show you an example program. How to develop a simple network based application using socket programming. So to create a socket programming, so I'm going to use PyCharm IDE. So here I have created a project called network. So here to demonstrate socket programming, we need two programs. One is server and next one is client. So I'm going to create two programs under this project. So first let me create a server. Now server program is ready. Similarly, I'll create another program called client. So two programs created. So now coming to the server, in server side, what we have to do is we have to create a socket, then bind the socket, then we have to listen the socket, then we have to accept. So now let's see how we can create a server socket. First, we have to import socket. From socket, import everything. Then we can create a socket using socket function. Inside we have to pass the IP address format. AF_INET specifies that IPv4 address format. Similarly, we can set the type of the connection as TCP connection using socket_stream. Once you build the socket, we can bind the socket with the IP address. So I'm going to use my system as a local server. So I'm going to use localhost, and the port number I'm going to follow is 12,000. So once I bind the IP address and the port number, next I am going to use a listen function to make the server socket to listen for the client request. So now at this point, the server is listening. So now my application is registered as a 12,000 port number. So if any request comes to the 12,000 port number, the socket will be connected. So now I am coming to the client. In client, what we have to do is we have to create a socket. Then we have to make a connection. So already server is listening. So we have, using connection function, we can connect to the server. So here also we have to import a socket. So after importing socket module, let's create a client socket. So after creating client socket, we have to connect to the server socket using connect function. Inside we have to pass the IP address localhost, comma, the port number 12,000. So once this function is executed, we can ensure that the client is connected to the server. So in server side, so now server is listening in port number 12,000. The client is making a connection request. The next thing is we have to accept the connection by calling accept function. So in server side, we have to call accept function. This accept function creates a connection and it will return the connection object and the address of the client. So you'll be getting two return value. One is the connection object and next one is the address of the client. So to store that, first I'm going to store the connection object, comma, then followed by I'll be getting another variable called, another data called address. So these two data I have to store. Then we can call server.accept. So now the connection is created. So now server socket is ready and client socket is ready. So now let's check the output. First I'll run the server side. So I'm getting the message server listening at 12,000. Next I'll run client. So I'm getting the message connected to server. Here also I'm getting the message connected to client. So now connection phase is completed. We are getting the connection connected to client and connected to server. So next phase is we have to exchange the data. Now let's see how we can send the data from a server to client. So here in server side, we got two objects. One is connection object and next one is address. So to send the data, we have to use connection object and we have to use send function. Inside, while sending a data, you have to send as a byte format. For that, we can use bytes function. Inside data, if you want sent, you can attach the data hello client, followed by you have to send the encoding format. So there is a encoding, standard encoding format UTF-8. It is called as a universal transformation format. So now we can say that data sent. So this data I can read in this client side. To read the data in client side, for example, I can receive the data. Receive data is equal to client dot receive. While receiving, we have to give a buffer size. 1024 is a buffer size. This receive function returns as a bytes. After getting a bytes, you have to decode it. You have to decode as a string format by calling decode function. So after receiving the data, now we can display the data. From server side, I'm getting the data. So now let's see the output. So first I'll run the server side, run server. Then I'll run the client. So now in client side, we are getting the data. Server is sending a data, hello client. Sometime when you send a data from server to client, you want to attach a date and time information also. If you want to attach date and time information, it's very simple. You have to import time module. So by using time module, we can deal with the time. So when you send a data, we can attach that current date and time using cTime function. Just one function you have to call. So now let's see the output. First I'll run the server. You can look at the console window. The server is ready. And next I'll run the client. So now you can see the output. Hello client Friday. The date and time information also attached. This way we can send a data from server to client. So now let's see how to send a data from a client to server. To send the data from client side, we have to take the client socket. Client socket is a client dot send. Inside again we have to use a bytes format. Inside I'll send hello server and followed by you have to use the UTF-8 for the encoding. So data sent. So now in server side we can read the data using connection object, connection dot receive, and the buffer size you can give. So here also we can receive and we can store it in a variable. So receive function returns a byte data. We have to decode it by calling decode function. So this I'll just paste it here, data sent. Now we are getting the result data. Client is sending data that I'm going to display. So here. So now check the output. First we have to run the server. So you can look at the console window. So we are getting a listening at the port number 12,000, and next I'll run the client. So now you can see we are getting the message from client. We are get in client side, we are getting the message from server. In server side, look at the output. Hello server message is coming from client side. So like this, we can make a two-way chat application. Finally, we can close the connection by calling connection.close. So in server side, in client side also, we can close the connection by calling a client.close. So now one more time I'll run. So first I am running a server, then I'll run client. So now now look at the output. In server side, it is connecting to the client and it is sending a data. Also, it is receiving some data from the client. Then it is ending, process finished with the exit code 0. Similarly, client side also, we are getting a message connected to server. Then we are getting a message from the server. Then we are sending some data, right? So in real time, what we have to do is the server should not stop. So the server should not stop like this. We have to make the server run forever, 24/7. So in order to make that, the recommend way is when you create a server side application, what we have to do is we have to make the server running forever. So for that, we have to use a infinite loop. Using a while loop, we can do that to make the server running forever. So what you have to do is we have to apply a infinite loop while true. So this will make an infinite loop. So this you have to apply before sending and receiving. Close connection at the end you have to keep, close function. So the sending and receiving functionality you have to enclose with a while true. So now look at the server side, it is sending a data hello client always. So this we can make it as a dynamic. We can take the data from the user. For example, data is equal to input. You can ask the user to enter the data, for example server colon. So it is waiting for the server data. That data I'll just send inside the bytes function. So this is not necessary. Okay, so now it is sending that whatever user type, it is sending the data. Similarly, we can receive the data from the client side. So in the client side also, what we can do is we can repeat this process so that we can create a simple two-way chat programming. So what we can do is in client side also, we have to make a infinite loop and you have to enclose the sending receiving logic, receiving code and sending code logic inside the infinite loop. So here also, here I am sending a data. So before sending a data, let me ask the user to enter the data. So data is equal to input client. So this data I'll send. So the user, whatever user enter data, we are going to send from the client side. So this is a two-way chat application program. So here both server can communicate each other. So whatever data user type, you can send here. Now this data send, I'll remove it. That is just for testing. Now this is a simple chat application using socket programming. So where the server can perform both sending a data as well as receiving the data. Similarly, client also receiving the data and as well as sending the data. So now let me show you the output. So I'll run the server. Now look at the console window. Then I'll run the client side. So now from first we are actually in server side only we are sending the data. The server side only we are sending the data first. So initially we have to send the data from server. Now look at the output. In the client side, the hello message is coming. Now from client side, I'm sending another data to server, welcome. So now in server side, you can see that welcome message is coming. From again I'm sending another message, hi, from server. Now in the client side, you can see the hi message. Similarly, I can send another message, Goodbye. So server is sending another message. Bye. Like this, we can implement a simple chat application using a socket programming concept in Python. So thanks for watching this video.